x tangent inverse x minus and this integral x divided by 1 plus x square dx. Now here I need some additional steps from outside the question. Dear students, you see here in the denominator is 1 plus x square and in the denominator there is x, and I know that if integration involves function whose derivative is in the upward direction, like I have already told you that if you have du divided by u, means u is a function and du is its derivative, so the integration of this is ln u plus c. So dear students, x tangent inverse x minus 1 by 2 2x 1 plus x square dx. Here you can see that I have multiplied the function with 2 and divided with the same 2. So this means that I have made it just solvable. There is no extra addition. This is x tangent inverse x. This is minus 1 by 2. And dear students, you see 1 plus x square is the function and its derivative is 2x, which is in the upward direction. And you know, when you have a function whose derivative is in the denominator, so integration of that, just natural log of that function plus c. So as we have 1 plus x square and 2x is the derivative of this 1 plus x square, and we are going to integrate it, so its integration is just natural log of 1 plus x square plus c, and thus we have integrated this by parts technique and we got this solution. Now dear students, here we are going to try another question. In the same question number 3 part f, question number 3 part f, and it is px cos x dx. Dear students, here the two functions are multiplying, and the one is exponential function and the other is trigonometric function, and these two functions are multiplying. And you see the integral sign that we are to integrate the product of these two functions. So obviously we are going to apply by parts technique. Now it doesn't matter which one you call one and the other one is second, which one. So I am just calling exponential function is first and cos x is just second. And now applying by parts technique, so the first function is left in its original form and this is multiplied with the integral of the second function. Similarly, minus big integral derivative of the first function, which is exponential function in this problem, and integration of the second function, which is cos x, in this particular question. Now dear students, exponential function and the integration of cos x, the integration of cos x is just sin x. So we have integrated this and we have written the result. Minus big integral, the derivative of exponential function, the same exponential function, and the integration of cos x is sin x dx. Dear students, you may call this integral, let's say p, and this we have called p because you will see that during solution it will rotate, it will come again and again. So this is exponential function ex sin x minus integral. Now dear students, you see again that we have tried by parts technique to solve this integral, But again we encounter with the two functions which are multiplying and we are to integrate it. So dear students, here again on this portion of the integration we will apply by parts technique. So put square brackets, take this is first and this is second. The again applying by parts technique, ex is left, integration of sine x is taken, minus big integral, derivative of exponential function, and integration of the second function is taken inside this big bracket. Now we are going further, ex sin x minus ex and integration of the sin x. This tells you that you have to integrate sin x. Integration of sin x is minus cos x. Similarly, this is minus big integral. The derivative of the exponential function is again the same exponential function, and integration of the sine function is minus cos x. Because of this integral, we have to apply right the operator. Now this is ex sin x, this minus with this minus become plus ex cos x, and this minus with this minus become plus, but this plus with this minus become minus, and we left with e power x cos x dx. Now dear students, this same function that we are going to integrate is come out again, but I have called this p, so in place of this I can put p, ex sin x plus ex cos x minus, as I already called it p, so I will put p in place of this. This means that you have started from p and integrated it step by step, and so that p is now equal to ex sin x plus ex cos x minus p. This p will be shifted to this side, so this becomes p plus p, ex sin x plus ex cos x plus c integration constant. This becomes 2p. This is ex sin x plus ex cos x plus c. Now we need just p, so divide both sides by 2, so we get ex sin x divided by 2 plus ex cos x divided by 2 plus c by 2. And dear students, you know p is what? P was actually exponential function sin x dx, sorry, ex cos x dx, and in place of p I have put this value, and this p is equal to this, so this means this integral is equal to ex sin x divided by 2 ex cos x divided by 2 plus c by 2. And thus with this last question we have learned that how, when and how we will apply by parts technique. So let me recall you dear students that by parts technique is the very powerful technique of integration, and whenever you are facing the product of the two functions which is to be integrated, the by parts technique is the only technique which is to be applied there to integrate the product of those two functions. Now dear students, let me solve question number 4, part A, for further explanation. Dear students, I hope you will understanding what I am going to explain you. Now here is our question number 6 on page number 212. This is very interesting question. In the question they are saying that the rate of change of the voting population of a city with respect to time in years is estimated to be this. Means rate of change of voting of population, and they are asking for where n of t is in 1000. If n of 0 is the current voting population, then how much will this population increase during the next 3 years? So dear students, voting given data, rate of change, rate of change of voting population if population is represented by n, then the rate of change of voting of population is represented by dn by dt, which is given 100 t divided by 1 plus t square to the power whole square. Now we are going to find the number of population of the voting. But dear students, this function requires another technique, and that is what called partial fraction technique. With the help of that technique we can solve this, and without that also. So dear students, dn by dt is given us that this is equal to 100 t divided by 1 plus t square whole to the power 2, and we are going to find n. So we shift dt to that side, this become 100 t dt divided by 1 plus t square whole to the power 2. Now dear students, to calculate n we are to integrate it, because n is under the effect of derivative, and to remove the effect of derivative we have to apply integration. So apply integration, on both sides we have integral dn, integral 100 t dt divided by 1 plus t square whole to the power 2. Integration of dn will be n, and integration of 100 t dt divided by 1 plus t square whole to the power 2 is going to be solved by substitution technique, and for this let we can call 1 plus t square is just p. And now you see p is the function of t, so we will differentiate this with respect to t, and this become dp by dt, d by dt 1 plus t square, this is dp by dt, and derivative of 1 is 0, and that of t square is 2t. So dp by dt becomes 2t. Now shifting dt to this side, this becomes dp is equal to 2t dt. Now here you see we need 100 t dt, so we can multiply 50 to both sides to get that 100 t dt. Now dear students, you see we are going to put these two substitutions and this problem so that we solve this. So this integral becomes 100 t dt. 100 t dt is now equal to 50 dp. So I will put 50 dp divided by 1 plus t square is supposed p. So in place of this I will put p, and this will become p square. Now 50 will come out, and p square can be taken up, which become minus 2 dp. Now to integrate it, this is 50. And we will apply here power rule, and integration power rule, this becomes minus 2 plus 1 divided by minus 2 plus 1 plus c. Now this become minus 2, so this minus 50 divided by p plus c. And in last as p, you have supposed that this is 1 plus t square, so this become minus 50 divided by 1 plus p square plus c, and this is n of t, number of water population. This gives us number of water population. Now to find the difference or the change in the number of population after 3 years, so that can be calculated, that change in number of voting population is equal to n of 3 minus n of 0. N of 3 means number of voter population after 3 years, and n of 0 means that at this starting moment number of population of voter. So putting this value here in this equation, so you will get in place of t, you will put 3. So this become minus 50 divided by 1 plus 3 whole square plus c, minus, again putting 0 in place of t in this equation, this become minus 50 divided by 1 plus 0 square plus c. Now dear students, you see this is minus 50 divided by 10, and this become plus c plus 50 divided by, and this is minus c. This cancel. This gives you just minus 5. So minus 5 plus 50, which is 45. So 45,000 people are increased after 3 years for voting purposes. Dear students, I hope you have understood today's topic, integration by parts technique. And if you have any problem, any query, or you have any hurdle in your exercise questions, you may consult us. Thanks for today, and inshallah we will see in the next topic next time. Thank you.